Hi everyone, Grzegorz Baran here. Each environment PBR material has to tile in all directions, the way which isn't obviously repetitive. There are many ways and tools we can use to tile them. We can remove seams manually, which with a bit of practice can be quite effective. We can also use some procedural tools to speed up the workflow at the cost of seam removal quality, or we can tile them fully automatically using sophisticated AI algorithms. Some tools and techniques are quicker to others, some are more time consuming, some cheaper, some can be really expensive. It's worth to mention that the seam removal process is definitely a crucial part of any material creation workflow and has a really big impact on overall material quality. Any mistakes or shortcuts made at this stage can't waste all the hard work we put into previous stages. There are material types which are quite easy to tile, and for them almost every technique and tool can do a decent job. These are usually generic, simple materials like a sand surface, soil or solid rock surface. But for a bit more sophisticated surfaces with strong and expectable patterns like a brick wall or cobblestone, seam removal process can be really difficult and work demanding. These can be really time-consuming puzzles to be solved, and we pay with the really significant quality loss for mistakes or shortcuts taken during the seam removal process. To tile these materials, we usually need to introduce a very sophisticated and time-consuming techniques and a lot of patience. The issue is that many human-made surfaces like a cobblestone or brick wall, even if we have a very clear and predictable large-scale pattern, they are often very irregular and random on a medium and micro level. A brick wall I picked for this video is a good example of this type of surfaces and problems we might struggle with. This is the surface type which cannot be just tiled, but the tiling has to be believable and non-repetitive at the same time. This brick wall is also very irregular. Since it was painted, it lacks clean color distinction between different substance types it was made of. So, since both the brick and the mortar are covered with the same aged white paint, it makes it even tougher to interpret. With surfaces like this one, seam removal can take more than an hour of manual work of an experienced user and can be really frustrating. Usually, it's a puzzle with a lot of trials and errors and no guarantee of being well done at the end. Even if the manual seam removal process for this type of materials can be really frustrating and time-consuming, I would say that for textures like this, it used to be the only reliable option. Hopefully, until now. And in this video, I'm going to present how in an easy and relatively quick way we can tile textures like this one if we use an AI-based algorithm the Unity Artengine offers. Since this is not the video about the full photogrammetry workflow, I'm just going to mention that as a subject for this video, I picked an old, painted with a white paint brick wall. To capture it, I took 168 perpendicular to the surface 24 megapixels images. Next, I use PhotoLab to calibrate the color and basically tweak all images so I can get the best from them. With the Agisoft Meta Shape, I turned these images into a 20 million heavy high poly geometry and generated a 16K texture to carry color data. I used ZBrush to build a low poly PBR canvas model to define coverage for baking. I positioned it to cover around 2x2 meters area, with the top and the bottom edges being located between the rows of bricks. Next, with the Substance Designer Baker, I baked 4 PBR textures, a normal map, a height map, an albedo map, and an ambient occlusion map. The last stage left to be done is to generate a roughness map and remove edge seams so all textures we created tile in all four directions. My intention is to show how to automate this process without sacrificing any quality, and this is the main subject of this video. Of course, it can be done in a few different ways with different tools, but in this video I want to present how it can be done with the Unity Artengine and its improved AI algorithm. So let's jump into details. With the Artengine open, let's drag and drop all four baked textures into its workspace. Next, let's compose all textures together with the Compose Material node, so we can process them all at the same time, but also preview the result. Since we don't need metalness, let's remove this one from the input list. And since we don't have a roughness map, let's generate one with the Roughness Gloss Generation node. Let's preview composed material in 3D preview window. Let's take a closer look on seams we have. As you can see, there is sharp seam on all edges. It looks better on the top and the bottom since the plane used for baking was aligned with the horizontal gap between bricks to keep correct proportions and make tiling easier. But if we zoom in, we can clearly see another laser looking cut which has to be fixed somehow. To deal with seams, we need to bring a seam removal node and plug our material into it so the AI can get the data to do the job. The seam removal node is powered by the AI. To activate the AI, the node has to be executed. From the user point of view, the node is quite simple and has just a few constraints and guides used to communicate with the AI. The first one is the seam removal area. This area defines the space for the AI to do the job. This is the area where AI is going to do seam removal job until the seam is gone. The second one is the ignore input. This one tells the AI what area should be removed from the material and replaced with remaining data. The third one is the structure guide input. With this one, we communicate the areas we want to protect so the AI won't shift them randomly around. Both inputs to work need to be filled in with the white and black masks. Since we don't need AI to mess with horizontal brick rows, let's limit this area and set a very small threshold to cover just the space between bricks. The side edges definitely need more space to be tiled properly, so let's give the AI a bit more space there. If we execute the seam removal node now, the AI is going to do the job on its own and remove all seams, but since it has no more constraints, even if all seams are technically gone, the material doesn't look as we wish and the brick flow is broken. It's because the AI has no idea about the surface itself and doesn't know what do we expect from it visually. It would be totally fine for the sand surface, but for a brick wall it is unacceptable as clearly breaks the brick's flow and logic. And this is where another constraint comes in handy. Let's introduce a structure guide here. I like thinking about this input as a protect mask. With this constraint, we mark islands we want AI to protect and don't mess with their structure, and in result keep them relatively unchanged. So in result, the AI has to proceed with the puzzle while keeping these areas intact. To mark these areas, we need to create a mask and plug it into the structure guide input. To create a mask, let's bring a mask paint node and draw lines between all bricks. Let's plug the composed material as an input so we can preview all channels after we hit the C button and proceed with painting. We can change the brush size by holding Ctrl and pressing right mouse button. Since white is the color which marks protected area, we are going to invert it later. Bear in mind that the mask paint node can have just two colors, black and white, and even if we change the color to a different one, it's going to be changed and simplified to one of these. Black is the default fill color, so we need to paint using white color and invert the mask with the invert node later. The mask painting process in case of this brick wall is really tedious and boring. Even if we don't need to be very accurate, we still need to make sure that every brick is separated. Hopefully with the shift pressed we can draw long straight lines. Okay, I hope we didn't miss any brick. Now let's invert the mask and plug it into the structure guide input and re-execute the node. As I mentioned, we have to invert it as the white color represents protected areas. Now the AI will try to rearrange the brick placement while trying to keep all islands intact. As you can see, the result is way better. It's almost impossible to see the cut. This is the roughness and the ambient occlusion, the normal and the height map. Regarding the mask creation, in this case it was a really long and tedious process, but I did it to show you the idea behind it. We can create the mask using any external software of our choice or generate one using already existing data. It's just up to us how we do this. I painted this one manually to show the process. So let's give it a try and auto-generate mask from the data we already have. Since the height map is a very rich source of data, we can try to utilize it with the detect edges node and try to generate our mask way faster this way. I guess we can also try to use high pass node. With the auto levels plugged before to exaggerate the difference between the darkest and brightest value, and use the contrast node after to exaggerate the difference itself. We can also mix the results with the one we painted. I would say the sky is the limit here, and anything that helps us and speeds up the job is welcomed. It's worth to say that if we are not happy with the result, or we have some small glitches we want to be recalculated, and we want the AI to reprocess the data in a slightly different way, we can change the seed and re-execute the node. We can also play with the seam removal coverage area and repeat the process as many times as we want until we are happy with what we've got. As you can see, one brick is extremely repetitive. To deal with things like that, we have another very powerful constraint we can set for the AI. With this one, we mark areas we want to be totally removed from the actual material and replaced using remaining texture information. So if there is a very repetitive element on the texture we want to get rid of, like this brick, or a glitch we want to be gone, we just need to mark this area using another mask, plug it into the ignore input and re-execute the seam removal node so the AI can fix that for us. Before it's finished, there is one more thing I would like to fix with this material. Since the original brick wall was dirty at the bottom and cleaner at the top, when turned into material, it resulted with the very repetitive cross-surface color gradient. We can try to fix that by processing the albedo texture with the gradient removal node and set the gradient removal level to the one which works for us. We just need to be careful, as an AI used this information to interpret the surface, and if it affects the result, we might need to process this fix after the material was tiled. When we finally get the result we are happy with, we can export full texture set by adding an output node at the end. Bear in mind that this type of surface is really hard and tricky to tile. It lacks of clear surface definition. The height is totally irregular on a micro and medium level. Overall large pattern is very tricky and inconsistent. The surface is as hard to read and to interpret in many places that even I wasn't sure where exactly to paint the mask. Of course, I have seen worse texture, but I would definitely consider this one as a challenging to tile. Admittedly, we need to do some work to tile it with the Artengine, but it's not as complex as the job we would need to do if we would try to tile this material manually. I would say that the seam removal process with the Artengine is pretty simple and can be done pretty quickly. And what is a good thing is that it can be processed on really broken and glitchy materials with really inconsistent height information, and the results still should be mind-blowing. The Artengine does amazing job on a medium and micro level, which is usually the biggest challenge with the manual approach. And as a user, we just need to make sure that AI gets enough information and clear direction to follow from us. In my opinion, there is still field for improvements, things like a better surface structure recognition from different types of delivered data, especially the height map, which is, I feel, totally underestimated by the AI during the process. But honestly, I can't really find any better and most efficient automated solution for seam removal, and the way Artengine tiles brick walls, cobblestone surfaces or scattered rocks is just mind-blowing. So, is the manual seam removal still an option? Of course it is. Painting masks to communicate with the AI can be also time-consuming, especially for complex and glitchy materials. With the manual approach, we fully control what we do, and sometimes it can be the only option. Also, the manual approach seems to be a way cheaper solution when compared to the cost we need to pay to get the Artengine. But I would say that if I have 100 scans to process and I compare 1 hour long manual puzzle solving for each material with usually just a few minutes long seam removal setting an AI-based automated solution Artengine offers, I have to admit that Artengine solution is really a tempting one. And last but not least, the seam removal node isn't just the only stunning thing Artengine has to offer. And if you are interested, I can showcase even more of them in a future videos. Some, like an AI-based mutation nodes, are even more mind-blowing, as they give us even more automated options to deal with tricky and problematic data. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. If you like the content I deliver and you haven't yet, please leave thumbs up, drop a comment and subscribe to my channel. Big thanks to those of you who did it already, as it really motivates to create more content like this one. Stay safe and hopefully see you soon with the next one. Bye!